name is Pam, and I'm a program manager with the SQL Server engineering team. And today I'd like to do a quick demo for you on one of the new features of SQL Server 2019, memory optimized TempDB metadata. I've already done an overview video on this feature where I talk a little bit about some of the challenges with TempDB performance that you may have faced in the past and about the work we're doing in 2019 to improve TempDB performance. So I encourage you to watch that video if you haven't seen it yet. What we'll be doing in this demo today is focusing on the memory optimized TempDB metadata feature, how you enable it, how you would disable it, but also how can you tell whether you need to turn this feature on? Are you having the problem that this feature is designed to solve? So let's jump into the demo and take a look. So I've got a notebook open here in Azure Data Studio with a few commands. And what we'll start with is running the workload on SQL Server 2019 without enabling the memory optimized TempDB metadata feature. And we'll try to take a look at this contention that can happen in TempDB. So the first thing I'm going to do is start a performance monitor collection and collect a few different counters that will give us an idea of the performance of the workload. And then I'm going to use the OStress tool to run a multi-threaded workload. So I've got 8 processors on this particular machine, but I'm throwing 100 concurrent threads. So I've got a very busy workload here, and it's a very heavy TempDB workload. It's a basic stored procedure that creates a temp table, puts some data into it, and then selects from it. So you can see here in Perfmon, I've got some weights in progress, page latch weights in progress, and I've also got the average wait time listed here in Perfmon as well. So you can see I've got page latch weights happening while I'm running this workload. And that's not unusual with a heavily concurrent workload. The question here is, what are these page latch weights from? We don't know necessarily. They could be from your user database. They could be from TempDB. We really don't know just by looking at Performance Monitor where these page latch weights are coming from. So we want to head back over to Azure Data Studio and take a look at a script that can help us determine where these page latch weights are coming from. Looks like my workload finished, so I'm just going to kick it back off again so that we can look at that Azure Data Studio. Okay, so let's go back here. And I'm going to run this query, which I have in focus. And what this query is doing is looking at all the requests from DM exec requests that have a wait type like page, meaning some sort of page latch wait. And what I can see in the results here is that I do actually have several sessions that are waiting on page latch. And if I look at the wait resource, I can tell just from the wait resource that they're in TempDB, because the wait resource here is 21120. 2 is database ID 2, which is TempDB. 1 is file number 1. And then page 120 is the page number. So I can tell it's in TempDB. But if I use this new function called DMDB page info, what this allows me to do is take that page resource and crack it open and see what exactly is on that page. And so from that DMDB page info function, I get this object name. And you can see here that the object name is sys schema objects, which is a system table. So this is that TempDB metadata contention that we were talking about. And this is the problem that memory optimized TempDB metadata was introduced to solve. So let's go back to our command window. We can see that it finished, and both times it executed, it took about 52 seconds to run the workload. And we can, of course, see the page latch waits happening, and we can see the batch requests per second, which are topping out at, let's see here, about 350 maximum. Okay, so that's without the feature turned on. So let's go ahead and turn the feature on. In order to do that, we need to enable the feature in SQL Server, and we also need to restart the server. This alter server configuration command here requires a restart. So we're going to set that memory optimized TempDB metadata on, and then I'll go ahead and restart the server. And then once I do that, I will be able to come back to Azure Data Studio and run another command, this select server property command, to see if the TempDB memory optimized metadata feature is on. So let's run this command, and you can see it executed and the feature is now on, it's 1. So let's go ahead and run our workload again. Let's start perfmon. Let's kick off the workload again. Same exact workload, same stored procedure, 100 threads. And you might notice something different in perfmon right away. First of all, batch requests per second is much higher. We are going up to over 500, and it might even go a little bit higher. I'll let that run for a while. But also notice those page latch waits are gone. No more page latch waits. And if we come back to Azure Data Studio and I run that command again to look at the sessions, notice there are no sessions that are waiting on page latch. We've completely eliminated the page latch waits. And if I come back to perfmon, yep, my workload is already finished. So you can see I've improved throughput. I have eliminated those page latch waits. And if I come down to my workload, it's now completed in 35 seconds versus the 52 seconds without the feature on. So this feature is designed to allow you to help scale up your heavy TempDB contentious workloads without making any code changes at all. You simply turn on the configuration, restart the server, and then you can immediately have improved throughput and less page latch waits on your TempDB contentious workloads. So I hope that helps you learn a little bit more about the feature, how you would use it, how you would know whether you need to turn it on or not, and get you a little bit more excited about the improvements that are coming in SQL Server 2019. Thanks very much.